Whether crypto advanced or unspeakably new, Bitcoin.com has a wallet for you.
This upload is part of a series. With permission, Dave Ridley is converting Crypto Insider articles to audio files about 20 minutes long. This can help you learn about the alternate currency world while you are eating or driving. Ridley doesn't necessarily endorse the opinions expressed in the articles. Is Wall Street developing a taste for Bitcoin? Posted by Michael Kern, Vertical Line, November 21, 2017. Bitcoin has soared past the market caps of Morgan Stanley NYSE/MS and Goldman Sachs NYSE/GS, and despite a few naysayers, Wall Street seems to be growing fonder of the cryptocurrency. Back in September, Jamie Dimon, the head of J.P. Morgan NYSE/JPM, called Bitcoin a fraud, and even went as far as saying that its investors are stupid. On the other end of the spectrum, Morgan Stanley's boss, James Gorman, stated that Bitcoin is certainly something more than just a fad. He went on to say that the concept of anonymous currency is a very interesting concept, interesting for the privacy protections it gives people, interesting because what it says to the central banking system about controlling that. CME will trade Bitcoin futures while not exactly Wall Street. The Chicago Mercantile Exchange CME recently announced that the exchange will begin Bitcoin futures trading in December, the first U.S. exchange to offer trading options on the cryptocurrency. Futures are a financial contract in which a buyer agrees to purchase an asset, or a seller agrees to sell an asset at a predetermined price. Futures are often used as a hedge or to speculate on future price movements of an asset. CME's move was met with talk of tulips, bubbles, and Ponzi schemes from the traditional traders. While Bitcoiners had their own FUD, market movers would manipulate the price and involve the cryptocurrency in everything that is wrong with the stock exchange. For now, it's impossible to know what will happen, but it is worth a small history lesson. Background. In 1982, CME brought futures to the S&P 500, acting as a catalyst for a rally across the market lasting nearly 5 years. Futures added a new way to speculate on the market, which led to traders bidding up the price of assets across the board. Using program trading, the simultaneous buying/selling of stocks and related futures contracts, traders sought to exploit the differences in prices throughout different markets, or engage in arbitrage strategies. When volumes dwindled, and prices remained artificially elevated, these program traders initiated massive sell-offs, resulting in the 1987 stock market crash, otherwise known as Black Monday. Following the Black Monday, regulators moved in, creating circuit breakers, or trading curbs, allowing exchanges to halt the trade of specific stocks, futures, or assets to avoid huge price declines. CME Group's involvement in Bitcoin futures brings circuit breakers into cryptocurrency trading, the way to rein in some of the volatility that is synonymous with Bitcoin. Though this practice may not keep investors as safe as the notion suggests, in fact, in some cases, it could amplify the very problem that it seeks to avoid. In 2015, China experienced a market crash and added these circuit breakers, and in January 2016, they were put to the test. The circuit breakers were meant to kick in at different levels, 5% loss and 7% loss, shutting down the markets at each position. This led to massive sell-offs as the losses approached these levels due to investors trying to shed their losses before trading was suspended. A major problem in this example was that the triggers for the shutdowns were both too low and too close together, sparking a huge wave of panic selling. Futures in Bitcoin trading, as of this writing, have relatively little precedent. When Segwit2x was announced, Bitfinex, HitBTC and Akrate offered futures on the since-botched Bitcoin fork. Investors saw prices head above $2,000 at one point, only to crash by nearly 90% when the fork was called off. While Bitcoin itself is already a legitimate asset, it does bring into question the impact of Wall Street-style speculation on digital assets. Bitcoin backers are typically aware of the intense volatility associated with the cryptocurrency, as price swings of 20% or more are not uncommon. Many argue that this is simply the result of a natural trading, unregulated and pure, and Bitcoin's relative adolescence brings a number of factors into the trading process: fear of missing out, FOMO, fear, uncertainty, doubt, FUD, and the general excitement of something for a new generation of investors. As Bitcoin goes mainstream, there will undoubtedly be several schools of thought looking to spread their own gospel, but one thing is clear: there's no stopping its progress. Investors should be aware, and enthusiasts should be patient. Some may see that Bitcoin heading to the stock market makes it more legitimate, while others may suggest that it is already legitimate. For better or worse, those who aren't interested in getting involved in the stock market still have options, while those who have wanted to get involved in Bitcoin, but feared its lack of regulation, will have their own options as well. No one can be sure how this will go, but it is likely going to be a wild ride, so hang on tight. Next article follows. Daily Roundup, November 21, 2017, posted by Kyle Torpedo. According to CNBC, Bitcoin rebounded to a new all-time high on Tuesday in the aftermath of the hack of Tether's treasury wallet. Over at the Tether blog, the company behind the USD-backed token issued on the Omni protocol announced that they had been hacked. According to a editor, the hacker is the same individual or group who hacked Bitstamp back in 2015. According to the Globe and Mail, Canada's largest pension fund is monitoring the Bitcoin and blockchain space, however, they do not yet see it as investable. According to Bloomberg, wealth managers are being hounded with calls about Bitcoin. According to the Wall Street Journal, J.P. Morgan is weighing their options when it comes to helping clients trade Bitcoin futures. This comes after J.P. Morgan CEO Jamie Dimon referred to Bitcoin as a fraud earlier in the year. Next article follows. Ponzi coin, BConnect's impending collapse, posted by Matt B. Vertical Line, November 22, 2017. Background. Scams in the crypto space are as old as the Genesis block. From ICOs setting impossible goals to shady websites promising airdrops in exchange for your private keys, there is no shortage of elaborate schemes attempting to part you with your coins. It's tough to empathize with those investing in poorly thought-out business models, then they tank. It's also tough, however, to convince people they're investing in a Ponzi, particularly when that Ponzi boasts a market cap of over $500 million at time of writing. Still though, the cult-like world of BeConnect should throw up a few red flags to anyone with any common sense. The supposed genius of the platform is down to a trading bot that averages returns of 1% a day. If you think about it, you're actually better just holding Bitcoin. How it manages such a figure is beyond me, and probably will be for some time. There's no proof of this magical software actually existing at all. The BeConnect coin BCC is traded mainly on the site's exchange, and can be purchased for Bitcoin. The better trade for the devs pocketing the Bitcoin than the users, surely, considering the BCC really only acts as an IOU. Users earn interest for loaning their coins back to the bot. Of course, the loan is locked in for the best part of a year for smaller investments. BeConnect incentivizes recruiting other users. We all have the friend on social media preaching about empowerment while trying to sell you overpriced nutritional supplements and hiring you in the process. This is like that, but with cryptocurrency. The more people you bring onto the platform, the higher returns you earn. You might recognize this model as a pyramid scheme, but fear not. BeConnect have opted for a horizontal approach, so it definitely isn't one. Occam's razor here would lead to a fairly simple conclusion. There is no software running the show. In a textbook high-yield investment program HYIP, the money being brought in by new investors is probably being used to pay off those further up the pyramid. It doesn't hurt that Bitcoin is accruing so much value. There seems to be a misconception that, since others are making money, it can't possibly be a scam. That's incorrect. These schemes work because the model is sustainable, provided there's a constant influx of new users. The house of cards comes crumbling down when said influx dries up, or when the team behind BeConnect decide to pull the plug. When you delve into the following the platform has, things begin to get weird. They hosted an event in Thailand in October, launching their smart card and, brace yourselves, the music album. Despite tickets only being available to those who'd invested at least $20,000 in one transaction, there was a huge turnout. I highly recommend watching the video, or you could just skip to this to get the gist of the conference. Catastrophic consequences. Watching the implosion of a Ponzi scheme of this magnitude in cryptocurrency is a much bigger deal than watching, say, Madoff's empire fall apart. Bitcoin is only just beginning to shirk the stigma of being a criminal currency with regards to the dark net, and probably could be doing without the bad press in the tabloids of now evolving into a white-collar criminal's financial fraud vehicle. I think ICO mania will have the same detrimental impact when that bubble pops. As with hostile Bitcoin forks and the Bitcoin.com scandal, the danger is not to the veterans of the cryptosphere, but to the newcomers. It doesn't help that BeConnect bears a name incredibly similar to that of Bitcoin, or that the developers behind the platform are touting Bitcoin as the reason their bot works. Regulation is clamping down fast on cryptocurrency, and the more money getting pumped into BCC, the worse for crypto users in the long run when legislators are unable to separate the legitimate from the scams. It doesn't help that supporters of the platform boast a healthy YouTube following. I won't name them, but they aren't hard to find. Whether they know that BeConnect is a Ponzi scheme, and are merely leveraging their subscribers to make as much as they can themselves, or whether they're actually just clueless, the result is the same. This opens up some ethical questions for tokens going down the line. Notably, anonymous developers. Is this something that can continue? I tend to romanticize the privacy element of cryptocurrencies, but with projects that aren't entirely transparent, it's probably time that responsibility is assigned somewhere, especially given the amount of businesses now looking to hop on the blockchain bandwagon. It looks like BitConnect is registered in the UK, but many doubt the existence of any concrete proof that could lead to those behind the site. Time will tell, but in the meantime, I urge you to stay away unless you want to use my reference code. Of course, I'm making 6K a day and you could, too. Next Crypto Insider article follows: the implications of Iranian Bitcoin adoption, posted by Michael Kern, Vertical Line, November 2, 2017. Iran has flown under the Bitcoin radar for a long time, but as the government begins to focus on the country's technological developments, things may be changing. Despite increasing inflation, Bitcoin adoption has been a slow process in Iran for a number of reasons. Most notably, however, is the impact of decades of international economic sanctions on the country. Some of these restrictions target encryption software often downloaded from U.S. sites, which is controlled by the Bureau of Industry and Security, BIS, in accordance with the Export Administration Regulations IR. It may be worth noting that there are ways around these blockades, but it requires a bit more technological experience. Iranian economist Mortaza Imanirad noted, Bitcoin cannot be easily installed in Iran and therefore cannot have an impact on the Iranian economy. In addition to these sanctions which censor software, and even information regarding Bitcoin, the cryptocurrency remains in a legal gray area. Imanirad added, this money is not legal in Iran and Bitcoin transactions are not legal and legally unrecognizable, so we do not expect them to have any effect on the Iranian economy. Indeed, the Iranian Central Bank has long labeled commerce carried out with Bitcoin as not legal. However, the government has passed no law absolutely forbidding Bitcoin as a payment method. In addition to the low number of users in the country, this gray area has prevented businesses from accepting the cryptocurrency. The Iranian government may finally be warming up to the cryptocurrency, however. Iran looks to create Bitcoin infrastructure on October 25. Amir Hossein Devir, Iran's Deputy Minister of Information and Communication Technology, articulated the country's growing interest in regulating and creating infrastructure for Bitcoin use within Iran. While the process of creating regulation for the cryptocurrency has been ongoing since 2013, Devir's announcement was a promising step forward. The Ministry of Communications and Information Technology has already conducted a number of research studies as part of efforts to prepare the infrastructure to use Bitcoin inside the country, Devir said, adding arrangements are being made with the related organizations to put together the infrastructure as early as possible. With worldwide Bitcoin adoption increasing and sanctions on Iran relaxing, there are tremendous geopolitical implications of a new currency in the country, including the impact on the petrodollar. The implications of Iranian Bitcoin adoption as the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries OPEC's number 3 oil producer. Iran's role in the oil world is carved in stone. Despite sanctions, The country has experienced incredible success dealing with the world's most important commodity. Even as a member of OPEC, Iran is not exactly friendly with Saudi Arabia, and vice versa. A key talking piece of the recent Qatar-GCC conflict, Iran's vocal opposition to Saudi Arabia and Saudi Arabia's ongoing petrol relationship with the United States has perpetuated Iran's isolation in the region. Iran has long been an outspoken voice against the petrodollar, even encouraging trade in rubles or yuan as a potential alternative. But Iran's new push for Bitcoin adoption could create a new opportunity for international oil trade. As the country powers forward in cryptocurrency adoption, it is joined by Russia and China, a trifecta which consists of the world's largest oil producer and the world's largest oil purchaser, a relationship of which global powers have certainly taken notice. With international relationships between the West and countries such as Iran, Russia, and China becoming increasingly volatile, the implications of an apolitical cryptocurrency are an increasingly important development to follow. Global trade as we know it is already changing, but Bitcoin's impact has yet to be realized. About the author Michael Kern. Techs and living in Mexico. New tech enthusiast. Decentralization fan. Cryptocurrency enthusiast. Geopolitical junkie. Digi explorer. And music lover. I believe that we are on the cusp of a new frontier in how we will view the government, money and energy. Let's be a part of it. Together.
Why does the world look like this? Well, it's because you're using these instead of these. Admittedly, so am I sometimes. But if you're not using Bitcoin yet, you're missing the boom of the century. So go to Bitcoin.com, get their free wallet, find out what it's like to be in a free market. Whether crypto advanced or unspeakably new, Bitcoin.com has a wallet for you.